Fuck it. This album fucking sucks. Hope you enjoyed hearing that little bit of genuine music, because I promise you it's the only bit of genuine music in this entire fucking video. Let's all be totally honest with ourselves here. Six Feet Under, even at their absolute best, have always been an incredibly mediocre death metal band. Under the guidance of Chris Barnes, Six Feet Under has been responsible for some of the most generic, uninspired, repetitive, and outright cringeworthy material that you could possibly find within the spectrum of death metal. Their last two studio albums in particular, Graveyard Classics 4 and Torment, are easily the worst albums released in their respective years, and quite possibly even two of the worst death metal albums of all time. Hell, they may even be tied for the number one spot. Now, following the release of Torment, some people hoped that the addition of former Cannibal Corpse guitarist would do a lot to inject some life and enthusiasm back into Six Feet Under. But I was not one of those people, because the way I see it, if members of Municipal Waste, Iron Regan, Cannibal Corpse, the Black Dahlia Murder, Whitechapel, and the Haunted weren't able to do the same for Six Feet Under, then what the fuck chance does Jack Owen possibly stand? Especially when, at the end of the day, the lead singer, the primary songwriter, and the overall mastermind of Six Feet Under is still Chris Barnes, who at this point has aged about as well as a Nintendo Wii, or somebody doing an impression of Borat, or someone making a Monica Lewinsky joke. The fact of the matter is, Chris Barnes and Six Feet Under lost their edge, what little edge they had to begin with, a long, long, long fucking time ago, with Nightmares of the Decomposed only confirming just how clueless and lost Six Feet Under are within the modern death metal spectrum. The lyrics and instrumentation lack any sense of originality or spirit, often depending on some of the most obvious death metal cliches and the most tired death metal song structures. The production value is so bad for this album that it almost feels intentional. Like, if you were to tell me that this is actually a parody of a death metal album rather than an actual professional studio record, I might have believed you. And Chris Barnes, as a lead singer, has officially lost the fucking plot. There are a lot of ridiculous and almost irritating pig squeals across the record, seemingly interjected at random, as if to provide some kind of contrast. I'm not really sure. He can't even really do a proper death metal guttural at this point. He just kind of grunts and barks like a dog choking on a pork bone.
This is literally how he sings across the album. He just does this for like 40 minutes.
It doesn't help either that these are some of the most unenthusiastic and uninspired death metal tracks I've ever heard in my life. Tracks like The Rotting and Death Will Follow are some of the most boring examples of death and roll I've ever heard in my life, let alone from Six Feet Under. Tracks like Zodiac and The Noose are so poorly put together that it's almost unbelievable. Like, this does not sound like the work of a professional death metal band. This sounds like the work of a bunch of teenagers recording in their stepdad's garage. And it's genuinely hard not to genuinely cringe on tracks like Drink Blood, Get High, and the arguably questionable Dead Girls Don't Scream, in which Chris Barnes tells the story of a young man who rapes, tortures, and murders a young woman simply because she dared to reject his advances. Now, don't get me wrong here, I'm not opposed to a little bit of extremity in my music, and I'm well aware that Chris Barnes has always been a very violent and explicit person in his songwriting, but this particular subject matter in 2020 is a little bit too close to incel pandering for my personal liking. Now, I will concede that, all things considered, Nightmares of the Decomposed is probably still a better album than Torment, and definitely better than Graveyard Classics 4. But honestly, all of these albums are so terrible in all of their own unique, respective ways that I don't really see the point in having such an argument. Like, comparing Nightmares of the Decomposed to Torment to Graveyard Classics 4 is quite literally the equivalent to comparing shit to diarrhea to explosive post-Taco Bell diarrhea. Yes, I would obviously much rather have shit, but at the end of the day, it's still fucking shit. This is a 0.5 out of 5 for me. While it is not hands down the worst thing 6 Feet Under have ever made, it is definitely one of the worst things they have ever made, and it is definitely the worst death metal album of 2020, and one of the worst albums in any genre, period, in 2020. It honestly blows my mind that a band with the resources of 6 Feet Under signed to Metal Blade Records is capable of putting out an album so fucking terrible, so fucking amateur. Like, seriously, as we speak right now, as you are watching this video right now, there's a fucking sweaty edgelord somewhere in the world who is working on a death metal demo that sounds objectively better than every single moment of this studio album. Hell, I could probably make a better song than 6 Feet Under right now. Let's give it a shot.
The bodies are rotting in the streets. I'm fucking edgy.
I don't even think this guitar is in tune right now, and I still think I just wrote a better song than the entirety of what is found on Nightmares of the Decomposed. Shit, maybe I should be put in charge of writing the next 6 Feet Under album, am I right? I noticed on a video from Metal Trenches, one user by the name of Interdimensional Entity said that 6 Feet Under is death metal's answer to Tommy Wiseau's The Room. I respectfully disagree with that statement, and if it's all right with you folks, I'm just going to share with you what I said to Interdimensional Entity in response to that statement. As bad as The Room is, at least I can tell there was genuine, if misplaced, passion from Tommy in every aspect of the film. And on top of that, it's genuinely kind of entertaining in a super ironic way. I'd say Nightmares of the Decomposed is death metal's answer to Justice League. We knew it was going to suck because everything before it sucked, but it's still wildly disappointing thanks to oodles of potential talent and resources and cash being so transparently and almost unapologetically wasted. And with that in mind, I can very honestly say that I am done with 6 Feet Under. This is the last time I will review any album of theirs on the Metal Meltdown. There's just no fucking point anymore, folks. They are clearly not listening. They don't want to listen. It's the reason why they've blocked all comments on all of their videos for all of the promo singles attached to this album, and for that matter, every other 6 Feet Under album. If they can't be bothered to make a competent record or to even hear us, then I'm simply not going to patronize them anymore, and I hope that you make the same decision. 0.5 out of 5, a truly insulting fucking record. And, that's it, I guess. Press this button right here if you liked what you saw here today, and you want to get updates on the Metal Meltdown e-fucking immediately. I am going to drink this bottle of vodka, and then I'm going to go to bed. Fuck 6 Feet Under. Yeah, that's it. We're done here now. Goodbye, everyone.